we see across many different metabolic processes in many different target tissues, we see beneficial effects of ketone bodies. Now, many of these studies are done in rodents or in cells or preclinical models, and it's only now that we're beginning to get a handle on how these might relate to human physiology. But the point is that the potential is there, and over the next number of years, I'm sure we're going to get answers as to whether these preclinical promising results translate into real effects within humans. My research over the last number of years, if it has taught me anything, is that context really matters. And so I've been involved in research that's looked at how muscle adapts to exercise. I've been a practitioner working with everyone from para triathletes to team sport athletes to combat sport athletes, and then in the clinical realm looking at healthy aging. And the point really that I'm trying to make is that when you get a perspective of all of these different types of context, you begin to realize that each piece of advice probably needs to be specific to a given context, and you just can't make these kind of catch-all statements around what any form of therapeutic can do, whether that's exercise or diet or nutrition supplements. Like I said, the potential roles of ketone bodies as therapeutics is numerous. And so there's a whole series of studies that have come out around appetite, cognitive function, muscle regeneration, anti-catabolic effects, and reduction of glucose response to a meal. These are all things that have been established either in human or rodent models for effects of ketone bodies. So there's little doubt that ketone bodies are a prolific metabolite when it comes to exerting metabolic effects across a range of tissues and processes. The work now needs to be done to really drive this home in terms of human studies.